بشاري لا وهاني الممرح لا وعذاب ساري الخلابة ومزوية وقريبته مليونة
Every deep-rooted nation has its own heritage of culture and civilization on which it prides itself among other nations. And every race has its own tradition of folklore, dance, songs and music, distinguishing it from other races. By virtue of being bounded by both sea and desert, Kuwait has acquired its arts from these two forces of nature. True folklore is a strong link between the rising generation and its ancestors. Bedouinism as a mode of life is as ancient as man. Bedouin art in Kuwait is simple and free of complications, and its simplicity can be seen in the decorations and ornaments made by women to beautify their clothes and palanquins. The authenticity and attraction of Bedouin art is reflected in the various types of songs, such as Hijani and Hada. Hijani singing expresses the lover's plight and passion, in addition to sentiments of pride, praise, and slander.
ورانا ما جانا اليوم من احد اما احنا جانا هنيه واتف بيت واتف بيت والارض يعني على ربيع من قبل
ان شاء الله
الحمد لله الخير واجد ان شاء الله والله يطرح البركه
هذا ابو
صالح ابو صالح حيا الله
السلام عليكم
عليكم السلام يا هلا ابو صالح
يلا
حي
يلا حي
يلا تبقى
يلا
حي يلا ابو صالح معنا اليوم ولا لا جره نشوفها داهم هالمطر داهم
كلها عربان ولا
صحيح ولا الارض كلها عربان
ما يقدر عن الفرجة
الحال انا الصبح لقيت لي جرة قطعة بعير حول 15 20
السلام عليكم
السلام عليكم
نوخو نوخو يا نوخو
ان شاء الله
يلا حيهم يلا حيهم يلا حيهم يلا حيهم
السلام عليكم
يلا حيهم
يلا حيهم
يلا
حيهم
يلا حيهم حياكم الله ناصركم ماجي
يا رب تسرع بالفرج والعوافي
The rubaba is a musical instrument known to man in one way or another since ancient times. It provides the musical accompaniment to the Bedouin leisure time songs, stories and ballads. In Bedouin circles, the poet or the singer is expected to be well versed in playing the rubaba on social occasions in the diwans and for evening festivities around the tents.
وقعدت انا مع لابسات الغدافي وسنجالي ساعت في ظهرها سبعة عشر ليلة جرى لي هرافي أزري تميز شمسها من قمرها صاح الصياح وجل ما من
Wood for shipbuilding used to be brought from the Malabar Islands, India, and the African coast, whereupon Kuwaiti artisans, with their skills inherited over the centuries, would shape it into a sturdy seagoing vessel. So, with rhythmic beating, we begin the first stage of building our boat, which will carry our hopes of a valuable catch out to the open sea. Building a boat like this used to take from 5 to 6 months. On completion, our ship is taken to the seashore, where the upper parts are rubbed with a layer of fish oil, while the lower sides are covered with gypsum and grease to prevent any seepage of water through the pores of the wood. And all this is done in a festive atmosphere, with special songs like Shuna.
Hey! الشهيد. عليكم السلام. هذا ابو صالح، هذا ابو خربه، كيف حالك؟
No ship could sail unless it had a complete crew on board. Abu Saleh, the old diver, comes to the captain's quarters to request that his son, Saleh, be allowed to join the crew as a diver.
عقب باكر تغدى وتمشى. اي
تمام الله
تمام الله. اهلا وسهلا.
On finishing the work of waterproofing the boat, the crew members start their leisure time songs, such as Sangini and Shubethi. These songs accompany the checking over of the completed parts of the ship.
خير كله هذا شيء بسيط، عطى المية بس 250 ابوك عليك من شوية ان شاء الله تاخذ فضيلة.
Tomorrow we sail, but today The crew members are paid cash loans to cover their family's requirements during their absence from home.
عليكم السلام يا هلا يا هلا يا هلا حياك الله حياك الله شوف باجي عبد الرزاق
شلونكم كيف حالكم
سلمت حاج كثر باجي عليه الحمد لله
شلونكم خير عساك بخير
140 عطى بعد 110
رسول الله يا رسول الله يا رسول الله إن شاء ربي كتب خبزي بشط غار ولا غصب على العين ينال من الإله أمره
be spending a long time at sea, working and facing risks together, hold a party prior to sailing to get acquainted. At this party, they sing popular songs, such as Al-Hadsani and Al-Haddadi. These songs are leisure songs, similar to Asamir, Al-Fujairi, or Salt, Al-Mujailsi, and Al-Arta, and are normally sung by town dwellers. Men answer the call of the sea and all its hidden treasures, and express their joy on this occasion through the authentic folklore songs, using hand clapping, the pestle and mortar, and the drums.
Thank you.
100 years ago, a diving expedition would last 4 months without ever going ashore. However, that period was later reduced to 3 months, for which our sailors must stock up with all the necessities of life. Ship is now moved from its berth into the open sea. This event, which is accompanied by a singer's voice and the humming of the sailors, begins with weighing the anchor. The sail is raised, and this is called al-katfa. This too is accompanied by the singer with clapping, beating of the drum, and foot stamping on the deck.
يا تشرق
عطنا عطنا
ليش عطيك زينك هل سلبحتنا انت
Now our ship sails to one of the many diving areas. Prior to diving, the sailors rest and relax, while some of the old ones are teaching the boy sailors the skills of seafaring, such as tying ropes and hoisting sails, even teaching them how to prepare and serve tea and coffee. The call of the kahur, heralding a change of direction for the ship, towards its destination. Now is the end of our journey. We must lower the sail and lay the oars in preparation for the pearl divers to begin. Unfortunately, we are not lucky this time, so we must move on to another place. The anchor is weighed, accompanied by a song called Al-Dawari, which is a work song backed by drums, hand clapping, finger bells and foot stamping. After lifting the anchor and sailing to another spot, the singer starts singing Al-Yamal. Because the journey has been long and tiring, the captain gives orders to raise only the small sail called Al-Jib. At journey's end, when this sail is lowered and wrapped, the sailors sing an appropriate work song called El-Nahar, also with hand clapping, drums and finger bells.
Thank you.
For the second time, our ship drops anchor for more pearl diving. The divers descend, each held by a rope bearer. And this time, luck is on our side. On the final day of diving, the flag is raised to signal the end of our journey. Not only was it a pearl diving journey, but a journey of interest into the world of Kuwaiti folklore, where we have had the opportunity to learn about the activities of pearl divers, who until recently were of great importance to Kuwaiti life. The day of return is an occasion for celebration on board and in the sailors' hometown. These celebrations are accompanied by leisure time songs known as Al Arda.